Hey there everybody, Eric from Outer Limitless coming at you today with another video. Now I'm out here today on this absolutely beautiful and wonderful winter day, getting ready to start a fire, gonna do a little bit of cooking outside, thought it would be a great opportunity just to enjoy the time out here. And today what we're gonna look at is these Woodcrafter gloves from the company Helikon-Tex. Now, even though it's a winter day, it's pretty warm out here, so I don't need any very substantial gloves. And I'm going to be doing a lot of work with tools, and, you know, it is still snow on the ground, and I want something to protect my hands, and these Woodcrafter gloves are going to be absolutely perfect. Now, these are not insulated. They are thin, just straight-up leather gloves, but I think these are going to be absolutely perfect for this task. So, with that said, I have a whole bunch to do. Whole bunch to share with you. And if you're interested in seeing a little bit more about what I'm about to get into, do me a favor, stay tuned. Now before we get too far, I would like to say thank you very much to the people at Helikon-Tex who did provide this product for review. Now these Woodcrafter gloves are fabricated from cowhide leather. And when you look at my original unboxing video, you'll notice these were a considerably different color. Well, the first thing for me is when I start to get into the outdoors and utilizing my gloves, I definitely want to protect them to the best of my ability. So I went through a fairly extensive process to get these to the point where, if you look here, they are actually just a little bit stiff, but over time these will break in. And so I have completely treated these. First thing I did was I used snow seal and I lathered these up real good and worked all the snow seal in, and then I heated it with, you could either use like a nice hot hair dryer. I use a hot air gun very carefully to control the temperature, and that really opens the pores in the leather and allows the snow seal to penetrate, and just rub it in real good and really worked it until it was almost dry. And then at that point, I added a very heavy coat of beeswax, so natural beeswax, and worked that into the gloves. And that's why they're just a little bit stiff right now. But the beeswax is gonna do a couple things. First thing is it's going to keep them, again, continually waterproof, just like the snow seal, but at the same time also help to toughen up the leather, because I do intend on using these at length, and I think I'm gonna give them a pretty good workout. And then finally, I just wanted to deepen the color, so I went with just a little neat's foot oil just to kind of rub it back in over the top, and again, heated these up very well and got everything nice and saturated. And at this point, you can see they're this beautiful, even, dark color. So that's the first thing for me, getting a good pair of outerwear. If you need to treat it before you even use it while it's clean and brand new. And so now taking a look at these in detail, you will see that you have this stamp. So it says the original Helikon-Tex company, established in 1983. So stamped on both gloves very nicely. And you'll see that there are some features on these gloves. So again, made from cowhide leather. On the back here, you'll see this nice strap. Now what that does is basically allow me to tension that, and as I pull that tight, and you'll see these will loosen up over time. Again, right now they're just a little bit stiff because of the wax, but it helps to keep debris from getting down inside where your fingers are, which is a nice feature. I do like that. I think that's gonna work out pretty well for me, and especially since I do intend on using these for processing wood for a fire. You end up with a nicely reinforced cuff, just a good overall look. It's kind of stylish, looks pretty cool, and I can say I definitely like that. Rolling to the underside of the cuff here, you will see there is the logo. So the little Bushcraft Lineup logo. And again, these are part of the Bushcraft Lineup in the Helikon-Tex series. So if you look at their Bushcraft Lineup, these fitting nicely within that particular line. A nice reinforced palm, you'll see here. And then down here, well, you end up with this little lanyard, which allows you to kind of clip these together. So for example, they even come with a carabiner, and lashing these together, you can clip them together. And these can be easily clipped onto my pants. Now these pants here are the Pilgrim pants, and they're kind of made for this. And that right there is a nice little feature. So that's working out very well. And so now getting these Helikon-Tex Woodcrafter gloves to some good hard use. Now this isn't going to be the toughest test, but where I'm going to be processing some wood for a fire, I think it's going to be a nice test where I'm gripping on logs, getting my hands in a little bit of snow, and continually grabbing tools. So these Woodcrafter gloves getting a little bit of a test here. Now you can see here, grabbing onto these logs, again, not going to be the hardest test, but wood can be a little bit rough on gloves, and the Woodcrafter gloves doing a nice job to help protect my hands. And the best part is, I'm not getting splinters, I'm not getting abrasion, and the Woodcrafter gloves doing a nice job even to protect my hands from a little bit of snow. And so here, just selecting my logs, getting ready for an afternoon of fire, I'm going to need a good amount of wood to sustain me for the day. But you can also see here, clearing off an area and getting ready to do some splitting. Again, the Woodcrafter gloves doing a nice job to protect my hands. And moving forward, the first thing I was worried is that I wouldn't have good appropriate grip. Now, with the wax on these gloves, it can go a couple of different ways, but with the Woodcrafter gloves here, I had a very nice positive grip, no problem at all. These gloves do have a nice reinforced palm, and that palm adding in the overall capabilities and grip on these gloves. So chopping and splitting and working for a good long time, these gloves did a very nice job to protect my hands and did a wonderful job gripping onto the axe. And again, continuing to split this wood and time again, grabbing onto logs and throwing them in my pile. Again, the Woodcrafter gloves doing a great job to protect my hands. No hot spots, no fatigue, and even when grabbing onto the wood and ripping it apart, I had no problems whatsoever. And again, even though this isn't the hardest test, it's nice to put these gloves to use and give them a little bit of a hard time. And now at this point, creating a baton so I can get down to some smaller kindling. So at this point, this is really getting into a little more of dexterity. I mean, nothing that's super technical or super detailed, but at the same time, getting a little bit more refined in my chopping. So again, the Woodcrafter gloves feeling wonderful and giving me a good positive grip. I have absolutely no problem here whatsoever gripping the axe and doing some of the finer chopping tasks. Bearing down on the log and also gripping onto the axe handle, these gloves definitely are comfortable and after a good amount of work at this point. But where these are called and considered to be Woodcrafter gloves, to me the absolute test is going to be doing some carving. So the ability to hold on to a knife handle and do a good job with controlled work. Here you'll see the Woodcrafter gloves doing a nice job to protect my hands, but also giving me the dexterity that I need doing some of the finer carving tasks. Overall, I have to say these gloves are very comfortable. They give me a good positive grip, and they are doing a nice job to protect my hands. Now, even in the batoning tasks, this is where it really starts to get a little bit rougher on the gloves. The wood of the baton, even though I carved it out and tried to smooth it out to the best of my ability, is still not really smooth. And I find that when I'm not wearing gloves, one of the harshest things to my hands is the actual baton. If I'm going to get myself some hot spots or even a blister, it's typically from my baton. So I know at this point I'm stressing the gloves to the best of my ability and actually starting to give them a hard time. But again, the Woodcrafter gloves having absolutely no problem at all, doing a nice job to protect my hands, and even shock through the handle of the knife isn't too big of a deal. So no splinters, no hot spots, and even protecting me from a little bit of shock on the knife handle, the Woodcrafter gloves are doing a wonderful job for the batoning tasks. And again, using these at significant length, at this point splitting through a ton of wood, they are doing a wonderful job. But what about those stabbing tasks? If there's going to be a problem with slippage, I will definitely see it here with the splitting tasks. So again, the Woodcrafter gloves doing a wonderful job. I do find that for the most part, I have good positive grip, and even slamming down with pretty good force, the gloves are doing a nice job. Now, it's not all the gloves' job, it's the knife's job too to keep me protected. So anything that was a little bit sketchy was more on the knife and less on the gloves. So again, the Woodcrafter gloves doing a great job to protect my hands. So all right guys, there we have it. A real quick look at these Woodcrafter gloves from Helikon-Tex. Now again, I would like to say thank you very much to the people at Helikon-Tex for providing these for review. So far, very good. I am happy with the way they feel. They feel perfect on my hands. I mean, just a good quality work glove, and that's exactly what I'm looking for. Something that's gonna give me some protection while I'm working. Now, granted, I did pretty much only use tools today. I did use the baton, so, you know, a little bit that was maybe a little bit abrasive, but no problems yet. Now, the long-term test will be as we get to use over time and really gripping on abrasive things, how are these going to hold up? I mean, again, time will tell, but so far I do have to say I am very happy with these. I like the fact that I treated them. I don't believe my hands got wet, but with that said, I know the gloves themselves did get a little bit wet, and it's not like these have a membrane, so at some point if the gloves got wet, I know my hands will get wet. But again, not a big deal. It comes with the territory. And, you know, leather gloves, leave them in the sun, let them dry up, you know, treat them well, get some treatment on them from time to time, and these should last me a good long while. And so all in all, I do have to say these Woodcrafter gloves are definitely cool. I like the style, I like the features, and the fact that I can actually just clip these onto my belt and keep on moving, that's pretty nice. So first things first, I tried them out, and I like them. But now, moving forward, what about that long-term durability test? Well, guess we're gonna have to wait and see. So all right guys, thanks for stopping by. I hope you like what you saw. Hope you found it a little bit informative. If you like what you saw, please like, share, and subscribe. And as always, thanks for stopping by. Take care now. I'll see you soon.